Hello everyone, I hope you are all doing well. MSI has just released a new BIOS update for their AM5 motherboards. And today, we'll be taking a look at it on the MEG X670E ACE motherboard. This update packs really interesting features. This is the reason I wanted to make a video for it. According to the version description, it says optimized for the Ryzen 7000X3D family and fixed a CPU temperature issue after resuming from SS3 state. Additionally, MSI also claims performance improvement for 7000X3D CPU in this version. I'll be testing two RAM related features in this update, one which is freshly introduced in this version. But first, let me tell you about the RAM model I'm using. It's the g.skill Trident Z5 Neo RGB kit, which is Expo certified. I've used g.skill in two builds previously and highly recommend this model specifically for Ryzen 7000 series CPU for its great frequency, timing, stability and performance. For all this in this video, I have Expo activated. To do so, go to OC and enable Expo. The profile sets automatically as long as your RAM supported, so no additional steps are needed. I usually don't overclock RAM beyond predefined profiles as manually tweaking timings often comes with compromising stability. However, MSI has made it easier more than ever in this update, and I'll show you why later on, so stick with me. Let's explore memory context restore feature, which basically minimizes boot time during restart, usually not called boots, by skipping RAM training in specifically code 15. Here I am comparing real-time footage with this feature enabled versus disabled, both with Expo activated. The system posts about 45 seconds faster with memory context restore enabled, but occasionally I get a blue screen of this in Windows. If you experience this behavior too, you can disable this feature, but it's worth trying it first. It may not always give that behavior for every system, so please let me know in the comments down below if it works without issues on your system. Alright, now let's dive into the more interesting part, the high efficiency mode. In the latest update, MSI added memory timing preset to this mode with options that are relax, balance, tighter, tightest, and naturally auto. I'll show you my results with each one. What this preset do is reducing timing between memory operations, leading to faster RAM performance. While my system couldn't post with the tightest setting, I got tighter working perfectly for days without an issue. Let me know in the comments if you tried this feature as well and got tightest working. It could be interesting to know someone got it working and what kind of results they got in some benchmark. To test stability, I used RAM test software. In advanced, I have CPU cache enabled, and going to testing tab, you can see the total and free memory. Also, you can set the megabytes that you want to assign for the test, and I recommend to not use all free memory so it doesn't freeze. Keeping some free memory is crucial for system to operate. Also, you can check the beep on error or stop the test. After running the test for 10 minutes with different high efficiency mode presets, the tighter had the highest coverage percentage, indicating faster RAM operations compared to when it was disabled. In 10 minutes, disabled mode reached 250% coverage, while the tighter hit 289%, a significant memory speed improvement without sacrificing stability. And as you can see, there is zero errors in all of them. And now, this is where it gets more interesting. By going to AIDA64 Extreme software and doing the benchmark, performing all four memory tests that are read, write, copy and latency. As you can see from the results, there's a significant difference between presets. With the title and read, we gained over 2000 points, and in write, it improved way a lot by achieving a whopping 90,000 points, an 8-fold difference. We also observed a 5000 point difference in copy and 10 nanosecond improvement in latency. I'm genuinely impressed by this feature. It's almost too good to be true. It increased performance by over 10% just by activating one setting, without compromising stability or manually tweaking memory timings. I highly recommend giving it a try. Before heading to gaming benchmarks, if you are interested in overclocking your CPU as well, be sure to check my other video here where I overclocked my Ryzen 7950X3D using BBO and got stable negative 13 curve optimizer across all cores. Okay, with that being said, let's go back to our RAM test and move on to gaming benchmark. I tested 5 games for you to compare performance. Enjoy! In conclusion, releasing this feature is a welcome addition to increase RAM performance without so much efforts and sacrificing stability. And guys, I really want to thank you for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, please subscribe to my channel to support its growth, allowing me to experiment and improve and bring you the high quality content you deserve. Thank you again for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.